then hold both hands, steady each other. That's what you're there for.
Yay.
Welcome everyone. Welcome today to the wedding, Stuart and Kathy. My name is Teresa, and I'm delighted and very honoured to be their celebrant today. Please take a seat. Kathy and Stuart have made the big step to seal their love of this very special wedding. So on their behalf, once more, I welcome you and thank you for sharing their very important day. Kathy and Stuart have decided that they are made for each other and they will take the next big leap into the future together. This day formalises their commitment to each other and represents their utmost desire to share it with you all, their special people, family and friends who have loved, laughed and supported them leading up to this day. So once more, thank you for coming. I really like hearing how couples meet and how they work together as a team, and these two are no exception. As many, many, many modern love stories start these days, these two met on Tinder nearly 3 years ago. But with always safety first in mind, Kathy decided it was okay to take the chance of a date with Stuart as he lived nearby. Apparently, she'd done a bit of research, according to Google Maps, they lived only 1,430 metres apart. Thus, there was no possible way that he could be an axe-welding maniac. Even as early as their second date, they both realised that this was something very different. This was a magnetic, immediate connection. And although the perfect date and the night of their first kiss, they also didn't realise that Kathy's daughter, Nevada, had spotted them snogging. After a year together, Kathy and Stuart combined their lives by moving in together. Kathy had spent countless research hours googling the various potential issues about a blended family, but all to no avail because everyone has just gelled. This momentous day was the 4th of July, and they both joke it has come to represent the lack of Independence Day for them both. Most of you know their family is a large, crazy mix of big personalities, all ages bundled happily together. Kathy has come with her tribe of three daughters, along with Victoria's two gorgeous girls, Matilda and Meredith. Although a little earlier than he imagined, Stuart apparently is very happy taking on the role of Papa Stuart. And of course, Stuart's two children round out this merry bunch. This crew love adventures together, travelling, eating out, and the beach is one of their favourite summer destinations. I have been told Kathy even broke her foot one year at the start of summer just to extend their beach time. It seems these two have fun as long as they are together, and this includes Kathy's enjoyment at destroying Stuart at backgammon. Friends and family keep telling these two that we can teach us. Friends and family keep telling these two that the honeymoon period will end, but apparently they have given up saying this now as they've realised for these two it's not going to be the case. It was on a romantic trip to Melbourne for Kathy's birthday that the proposal took place. Kathy made sure it was a birthday she would remember by proposing to Stuart with a set of couplets that meant memory. I have a feeling these two will create many more fun and wonderful memories together. And of course, it all starting today with becoming husband and wife. So now, Kathy and Stuart, we come to the celebration of the vows that lead you to your lives together. Stuart, do you come here freely and without reservation to enter into a relationship as husband and wife, promising to be faithful, supportive, and loyal?
Oh, yes.
Do you promise to support each other's dreams, walk beside each other, offering courage and strength throughout all your adventures?
Yep.
And do you promise to keep working together as this team, no matter what life may throw at you? Kathy, do you come here freely and without reservation to enter into a relationship as husband and wife, promising to be faithful, supportive, and loyal? Do you promise to support each other's dreams, walk beside each other, offering courage and strength throughout all your endeavours? And do you promise to keep working together as the strong team, no matter what life may throw at you? Here we come to the special placing ceremony where they will read vows to one another, and I am going to make Stuart go first. I'm right here if you want to still hold it, so you can keep holding your hands. Is that all right?
I'd like to thank everyone here for being here today. It's huge, hugely important for us that you're here, and also for the people that are overseas. It'd be good to see you guys again at some stage when we get this sort of global pandemic thing out of the way. So I, Stuart John Turner, take you, Catherine Elizabeth Dainty, to be my lawful wedded wife. So looking back to where our relationship started, as Teresa sort of alluded, it nearly didn't, because Kathy had determined that effectively she wasn't going to date anymore, because every bloke was going to be an axe-whirling maniac outside of her, area. I was actually within her area, so she worked out that I couldn't be an axe-whirling maniac, or maybe she meant the fact that I'd just go pillaging elsewhere. But those were her words. Pretty early on, we both realised, though, that there was something very special between us. Kathy, you are truly my soulmate. It's not something I believed in before. But I've become totally convinced since I've met you. Our connection and comfort with each other is unreal. With you, my world has expanded with love, fun, and of course, practical jokes. I will, of course, continue to spoil the ones you play on the kids by unintentionally grinning. I think that's my first thought. Kathy, I love your kind heart, your fierce loyalty to all of the family, and the way you always make me feel so special with the little things that you do. Even when you put your hands in the freezer and my back to show you. Even when I'm on Zoom. I love your kind heart, your fierce loyalty to all of the family, and the way you always make me feel so special for the little things you do. And I love the amazing, long, heartfelt messages you send me. You always find ways throughout the day to make me feel so special. And that's my heart. I love your quirky sense of humour. And even the way you poke your tongue out. You've got a problem. I'm totally convinced that I want to grow old with you. But it's got to be really, really slow. Snail's pace. So you can enjoy the time together. The future of us. Mrs. Kathy Turner. I promise to always love you, even when I'm 97 and I've lost my marbles entirely. I also promise to dedicate myself to keeping the spark, honesty, and trust we have between us aligned today and in the future. I promise to keep holding your hand wherever we walk. You can't sort of walk without you. And I always promise to keep our wonderful blended family first and to protect them all. Kathy, my final vow is that I'll always find ways to show you every day how special you are to me. You are my best friend, my princess, my soulmate. And it's us.
I, Catherine, as a Dainty, take you, Stuart John Turner, to be my lawfully wedded husband. Stuart, first off, I'd like to say thank you, because I am by far getting the better end of this deal today. I've never been this sure about love in my entire life. I feel like everything in my life has led me to do, all my choices, my mistakes, my regrets. And everything seems worth it, because if I'd done one thing differently, I might never have met you. Loving you is easy. You're strong, kind, and stable, respectful, and so humble. You give yourself in all your actions, humbly, and with kindness and generosity. You love with no ego, only with kindness, consideration, and respect. And you're truly sexy. Stuart, you truly do have a beautiful soul. But the way you love me is my favourite part of you. You love me without judgment, and you've chosen to see beauty in my flaws. You constantly inspire me to be a better me, a better friend, to make a better effort not to burn the kitchen down or the house. You make me happier than I could ever imagine, and more loved than I ever thought possible. Stuart, I'm completely in love with you, and the pinky promises I make to you today are the easiest pinky promises I think I could ever make. Firstly, I promise to never take for granted this once in a lifetime look. I think it's lucky you both in there, basically. And forever. I promise to always make fun with you, or at least kiss you after making fun of you. I promise to always work our love and always make you and our family a priority in my life. I promise there's nothing too difficult that we can't get through together. I promise to stay silly and never take ourselves too seriously and to laugh at horribly inappropriate things with you. I promise to always like you to forever have your back. I promise my hardest to try and step away from my stubbornness and accept that I make mistakes and that I am, to my horror, not always right. I promise to keep your life interesting and exciting and make marriage our biggest adventure. I promise to keep reminding you that sugar is unhealthy and to get that bulk checked because I want us to live long, happy lives by each other's side. I promise to support Carl and Bobby and help you guide them through life and always treat them with kindness and respect. Unless they try to talk to me before coffee. I promise to make our home one of laughter across many, many plants and love. But most of all, I promise to never give up. To always push myself to achieve the greatest for us in this marriage to ensure that we have a beautiful life. I promise to choose you and us and our family. And I promise to show you every day that I know exactly how lucky I am to have you in my life for the rest of my life. Love you. No, take that.
These two don't need me at all. Kathy and Stuart, you both have rings we'd like to give each other to symbolise the vows that you have made. The wedding rings are the physical signs of the commitment and love that bind you both together. It is important here again to acknowledge that today is a celebration of a loving couple creating a future together as a large family. So can I please ask our ring bearer to step forward with the rings? Stuart, could we have Kathy's first? Place it halfway through, just to the knuckle, and then repeat after me. I give you this ring as a sign.
I give you this ring as a sign.
That I choose you to be my beloved.
That I choose you to be my beloved.
I offer myself as your husband.
I offer myself as your husband.
Today, tomorrow, and always.
Today, tomorrow.
I give you this ring as a sign.
I give you this ring as a sign.
That I choose you to be my beloved.
That I choose you to be my beloved.
I offer myself as your wife.
I offer myself as your wife.
Today, tomorrow, and always.
Today, tomorrow, and always.
Kathy and Stuart, your rings become the symbols of the promises you have made today. On behalf of all of us gathered here, I extend to you our love and support in your marriage. May you honour, encourage and support each other as you go through life together. If your way becomes difficult, promise to stand beside and uplift each other. And know that through this union, you can accomplish far more than you could alone. On behalf of our team and with the powers vested in me as your celebrant, Kathy and Stuart, I now pronounce you lovingly and legally married. Stuart, you may kiss your wife. Oh.
Thank you. Thank you. They were waiting for this, weren't they? Stuart's just going to lead his wife over to that signing table for us. And we have Sean, Paul and Georgina, who's going to be our witnesses. Please feel free to turn amongst yourselves while this is happening, or we'll let our other people arrive.
I'm stupid. I'm a great source of people in that country. just at the time.
We're actually going to cut the cake, everyone.
Try and get out of the way.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you.
next year.
And
And I'm also sorry for yelling at you the other day when you tried to steal chocolate from me. And I love you both so much, and I'm just glad that we can now be one lovely family. So I love you both, and I guess again, cheers to
this moment, I've had to remove some of my material and the time we have to a minute and a half, I've had to remove all references to hookers, lesbians, the size of Stuart's manhood, and Kyle's real biological father. I'm not sure what's funny there, actually. I'll try and get to that in a minute. Okay, so Stuart, I'm really pleased to have been invited here as one of your groomsmen. I really do appreciate it, and you've certainly graduated from bachelor's, as they would be, to your master's. And when I say master's, it's not something that you've achieved on your own, because you truly do have a master. Her name is Kathy. But be honest, you still wear the pants in the house, but she will be the one who will tell you which one's still. So, I think you should be proud that Stuart can now call this wonderful lady his ex-girlfriend. But seriously, you did really well, Stu, with finding Kathy. Swipe, was it left or right? Swipe right. And Kathy, you certainly couldn't have found a better man. I've known Stuart for 30 years or so, to spend the rest of your life on this journey. And you truly, truly are very, very lucky. Both of you are. So, here's to the happy couple who knows the three secrets of a good marriage, which of course is alcohol, flavour, and great sense of humour.
Alright guys, these two are going to head off with the photographer, and we're going to bring you our cake.